Hello, in today's lesson we are going to speak about features of pronunciation and description of speech. Phonemes constitute the main basic unit of phonology. So when we speak about pronunciation, we speak about phonemes. The word phoneme is of Greek origin and it means sound. So what phoneme is? Here you have definition that phoneme are speech sounds as they are perceived. That is to say, this is pronunciation. When we pronounce words or sounds, we pronounce phonemes. Phonemes help us distinguish a spoken word from its written form. And for example, when we to help you better understand this word, this term, let us remember poems. All poems have rhymes. They have rhymes. Why? Because the endings of sentences have similar phonemes. That's why the words rhyme. And we have poems. And maybe when you were a children, you could play the game called Pig Latin, when we wanted to be to create our secret language. So we just shifted sounds or words, vowels or consonants, and thus creating a new words. And so trying in this way to hide the message, well, it's a Pig Latin. And what it means, that we just changed the position of some phonemes or sounds. And speaking about telephone connection, maybe you had experienced situations when you cannot understand well what the speaker is saying, and you mishear or you simply don't understand message. Why? Because some phonemes are not pronounced correctly, or you simply cannot hear these phonemes, and that is why communication is interrupted. And also, to better understand the notion of phoneme, we may speak about accents. We can easily understand, we can easily perceive someone's speaking your native language. When we speak about a foreigner person speaking your native language, you can see or you can hear that phonemes or pronunciations of some words do not sound as you pronounce in your native language. Why? Because foreigners, they tend to pronounce words or pattern words or sounds of foreign language following the patterns of their native language. That's why we have this phenomenon as accent. Some phonemes are not pronounced as we are accustomed to hear them in our native language. Well, main features of pronunciations are divided into big groups: segmental and suprasegmental features. Well, segmental features constitute vowels and consonants. Vowels can be composed by single vowels, and single vowels in its turn are divided, subdivided in short or long vowels and diphthongs or triphthongs, and consonants. That consonants can be subdivided in voiced and voiceless consonants. And another big group of features of pronunciation constitutes suprasegmental elements of speech. And within these elements, we have rhythm, intonation, length, tone, pitch, sentence stress, word stress, utterance, and syllable structure. These features are very important to be taken into consideration when teaching a foreign language, since all languages or majority of language, they have different rhythm and different intonation. Speaking about, for example, Spanish intonation, you can clearly see the difference between Spanish and English intonation, since in Spanish, for example, questions have rising intonation, and in English, we have falling intonation. So these elements should be taken into consideration when teaching foreign language. Also, next element, like length of vowel. For example, Spanish doesn't have phenomenon like vowel reduction, but in English, this element is present, and it also should be taken into consideration. Like, for example, in words interesting, beautiful, and more words, when we have vowels that have no stress, so these vowels tend to be reduced, and so we have a phenomenon of length. And some more elements like stress, word stress and sentence stress, also they are different in different languages, and it should be taken into consideration during teaching. Well, So, speaking about segmental features of pronunciation or speech, as you know, we mentioned already that we have consonants and vowels. So, what are the difference between vowels and consonants? This difference mostly consists in four aspects, like physiological difference. It's the way the sounds are produced. Well, you know that, for example, when we pronounce vowels, we don't have obstruction of air, and sounds flow very easily from a vocal tract. And when we pronounce consonants, we have different degree of air obstruction in the vocal tract and mouth, and we have different kinds of consonants like fricatives, stops, and etc. Well, another difference is acoustic difference, auditory quality of sounds between consonants and vowels. And next is role in the syllable. Consonants and vowels have clearly defined roles in the syllable. For example, vowels usually constitute the center of nucleus of the syllable, and consonants are marginal. And also, when we divide words into syllables, we do it according to position of vowels. And you know that all syllables, they have to be composed. Composed by consonant and vowel. Like in examples, you have dog, it's a one syllable word. We cannot split it in more syllables since we have just one vowel. Next, sail, again, we have a sail. You may say that we have two vowels like A and I, but when you pronounce it's one sound, one phoneme, it's a complex sound. That's why we cannot separate this word into more syllables. And if you analyze word beautiful or difficult, we can divide it in more syllables, but all syllables constitute vowel and consonant. So you see that vowels play a very important role in division of syllables. And next element is voicing. It's activity of the vocal cords. Well, and you know that all vowels are voiced and all consonants can be voiced, can be divided into voiced and voiceless. Well, and it's also when speaking about pronunciation, we need to know how sounds are produced. So we have a physiology of pronunciation, and you have a human speech apparatus scheme. It consists of three main groups. Like first one is respiratory apparatus, lungs in the upper left part of this slide. You have lungs. They provide air, which is used in the production of most speech sounds. And then we have larynx or vocal cords, where vocal cords are allocated, and vocal cords generate most of energy in speech sound, and they also are very, very important in production of speech. And the last one is the supraglottal cavities like mouth, pharynx, nasal cavities, which act as resonators for the laryngeal tone. And all these cavities are also very important when producing speech sounds. For example, if you have a flu or you have difficulty to breathe, so your sounds won't sound like M or N sounds, they won't sound correctly or will sound differently. Well, the next part that we want to discuss today, it's the physiology of pronunciation. Well, according to functions, all organs of speech are subdivided into articulators or places or points of articulation. It's the big difference between sounds, how they are produced and how they are articulated. Well, so articulators are movable parts of the vocal tract. They are organs or part of organs that produce speech. And here you have the main articulators. The articulators are constituted by lower lip, especially in production of sounds like P, B, M, T, and V. Then tongue. Tongue is subdivided into three parts, and all these three parts play a role in production of sounds. Like you have, like for example, tip of the tongue is responsible for production sounds like th, v, d, l, and middle part of the tongue, it's responsible for production of sounds s, ch, j, And back part, it's responsible for production of sounds like go, call. And vocal cords, of course, it's all sounds are product are produced with the help of vocal cords. It's impossible to produce speech without vocal cords activities. And places or points of articulation. Well, it's a place in the vocal tract where there is the greatest degree of obstruction. And we have upper lip that helps us in production of initial sounds like peel, bill, sounds like P or B. Upper from teeth and lower lip sounds like F or V. Well, next is lower from teeth. With the tip of tongue as articulator, and it helps us to produce sounds like th or th. And alveolar ridge that is located behind the upper from teeth, and it helps us to produce sounds like t and d, l and ch. Well, it is all for this class. Thank you very much.